Hi and welcome to another Zendesk Explained video, where today we'll be talking about triggers, how to set one up, and why they are the most important part of Zendesk support. So, conceptually, if Zendesk was a sports car, then triggers could be considered the engine. They're really important, and if you decided to turn off all of your triggers, well, Zendesk would pretty much stop working. So, what is a trigger, really? Well, when an event happens on a ticket, a set of rules, checks for something specific, and if those rules are met, then an action of your choosing takes place. So what exactly is one of these events that starts things off? Well, it could be when an agent makes any manual change to a ticket by clicking the submit button at the bottom right hand side. Or it could be when another trigger or automation makes a change to a ticket. Or it could be when an app or external service pushes a change to a ticket via the API. Basically, any update to the events log of the ticket constitutes an event that a trigger can fire upon. Ultimately, triggers react instantly to a change made to a ticket. But you might have also heard about automations, and these are different to triggers. They are time-based rules that run once an hour, and that is great if you need to bulk update large amounts of tickets or perform timed actions where the accuracy is only limited to plus minus about an hour. But given the instantaneousness of triggers, you'll be using these much, much more. Okay, so let's dig in and look at an example trigger. You'll find them by clicking into your admin center at the top right, then on the left under objects and rules, scrolling down and clicking on triggers. If you've just got started with Zendesk, you'll see a few default triggers in there that perform some basic functionality. And if you want to build your own trigger, you can do this at the top right or bottom of the screen. Let's create a basic example trigger to email all agents in support if an urgent ticket gets created. At the top, you have the name and description. We'll call this one Notify All Agents in Support When an Urgent Ticket Gets Created. Then we have Category, which allows you to group your triggers into different areas. We'll set this to General. Next, we have the Conditions section. This is where you define the rules for when you want your trigger to fire. There is a myriad of possibilities here to cater for just about anything that happens to a ticket during its lifecycle, from checking system fields like brand, form, type, what was said on a comment, what channel the ticket came in from, email, chat, web form, or the settings of custom fields. You can even check for how many Twitter followers a requester has. For this trigger though, we'll set it for when a ticket is created and the priority is urgent. Simple enough, right? Well, maybe not. It's important to note that the conditions section is made up of two parts. Rules in the first part all have to be true on a ticket before the trigger will fire, whereas only one of the rules in the second part needs to be true. So a common mistake that we often see in our customer Zendesk health checkups is instances where people add rules to either or both of these sections and then can't work out why it's not working as intended. Like, if I were to add both of these rules down here instead, this trigger would fire if either the ticket was created or it had the priority of urgent. In other words, it'd be firing under a lot more circumstances. On the flip side, if you were to split them and add one rule under meet all of the following conditions and add the other rule under meet any of the following conditions, then it would be no different from having them both under meet all. Because meet any of one rule just means that that one rule needs to be met. The meet any of this section only comes into play when you have multiple rules in it. For example, if I were to add, say, risk is very high, now the any part actually means something because the trigger would fire if either the priority is urgent or the risk is very high. So the distinction between these sections is something to be mindful of. And if it's a little confusing and you're not sure, then your best move is to keep all of your rules under meet all of the following conditions, because it's much simpler to understand at a glance and it avoids potential confusion for other admins looking at it. The final section is where you set your action. In other words, what you want to happen if this trigger were to fire. We'll talk about this, placeholders, and testing out your triggers in just a moment. But before, a note on SweetHawk. SweetHawk is the number one apps provider in the Zendesk marketplace with a growing array of over 15 apps that allows you to dial up your customer service to incredible. With apps like Tasks, that is more than just adding checklists on tickets, it turns Zendesk into a bona fide project management tool, letting you both automatically apply tasks and families of predefined sub-tickets with the click of a finger. Or what about the Notify app that helps you stop overwhelming your agents with emails, reduce swivel chairing, and start sending and receiving actionable notifications inside of Zendesk instead? So whether your need is around calendars, reminders, watertight approval processes, or enforcing down-to-the-minute SLAs, you can install Sweethawk's entire super suite of apps for one low price. Head over to sweethawk.com and get Zendesk apps that give you superpowers. Okay, back to trigger actions. As you can see, I can choose from a huge list of things to do on the ticket. Amongst these options, I can set it to email a user or group. So let's do that. We'll set it to email all of the support group with a subject line of urgent ticket and a description of, hey team, we've just received an urgent ticket. Get on it, ASAP. But if I want to reference something that's in the ticket so that agents know which ticket we're talking about, well, that is where Zendesk Placeholders comes in. Zendesk Placeholders are an incredibly powerful tool that let you insert information that is dynamically generated depending on the ticket that causes this trigger to fire. For example, if I wanted to reference the ID of the ticket in the subject line, I could use this placeholder, ticket.id. Or if I wanted to give anyone reading this email a quick link into the ticket, I could use the placeholder, ticket.link. In fact, you can use placeholders to reference anything within the ticket, and Zendesk have a great reference guide for all of the placeholders you can use. You can find it simply by Googling Zendesk placeholders like so. Now, you can continue to add as many rules as you like here, like setting the status, type, custom fields, doing something in a Sweethawk app, like automatically applying a task list or requiring an approval or popping up a notification. The sky really is the limit here. And once you've finished with building your actions, at the bottom, just click on Create. So now, how do you know it's working? Well, you can test it by creating a ticket and giving it the exact conditions that should cause the trigger to fire. So here we are creating a mock urgent ticket like so. Once we've performed the event that should have caused the trigger action to fire, we can check the events log of the ticket. And as you can see here, the trigger fired as expected and sent an email to all of these people. So yay, it's working. But let's say this trigger fired when it shouldn't have, then you can always click into the trigger settings like this to check that the rules have been set correctly. So there you have it, triggers explained. Note there are some nuances around triggers that haven't been covered in this video. So for things like common mistakes to avoid when building triggers, things you can't do with triggers, nullifying conditions, and the order that triggers fire in, be sure to subscribe and check out our other videos. Finally, if you'd like to get a free health check of your Zendesk, head over to sweethawk.com and at the top right of the screen, click on Book Demo. Thanks for watching.